All right, it's now 5:16. Let's take a look at that south split for folks hitting the road for any reason this morning. Mm-hmm. You'll want to check in with Marcus Bailey. We did have some snow overnight.
Yeah.
And a sad single-digit temperature, Marcus.
Very lonely, isn't it?
6 degrees.
It really is.
Trying his best there.
Yeah. I had to fill up my gas tank, too, because I wasn't smart enough to fill it up last night.
Marcus, you should have watched the weather yesterday.
You think I would have paid attention?
Tara told you all about it.
That was, I mean, it was bad enough that I had to wake up, and it's brutally cold, and I'm thinking while I'm getting ready, I'm like, oh.
You need
I have to go fill my gas
You're
tank.
You're one of those.
Too.
I fill up at like a quarter. I never let it get below a quarter.
Yeah.
It stresses me out.
So anyway, yes, what I did notice on my drive in, obviously light snow last night.
Right.
Nowhere near the amount that we had last Saturday. But because we are so cold, even main roads are in a little worse shape now than we were a week ago when we had several inches of snow.
It's because the salt doesn't work as well when it's as cold.
Chemicals have a tough time when it's as cold as it is. So I notice especially the on and off ramps and maybe like kind of the lesser used lanes, like the fast lane, were still icy. So keep that in mind because I don't know if that's going to really improve much today because we are going to be so cold. So weather alert both for the icy road conditions and obviously because of the chill that we have with wind chill advisory still in place for the northern half of the state until noon. Today, you've been seeing that scrolling on the bottom of your screen throughout daybreak here. These are air temperatures right now. Chicago at -4, Fishers at 6, Jeffersonville. It's a little bit better in southern Indiana. You're into the low 20s, but here in Indianapolis, as Brenna mentioned, we are at 6 degrees. A northwest wind just cuts right through you. It's 11 miles per hour. And our feels like temperature as a result is down to 9 below. It's worse off in many locations, especially north of Indianapolis, where you're talking wind chills at 14 below in Kokomo, 13 below in Lafayette. Look at Chicago, wind chill down to 21 below. It's 6 below right now in South Bend. So this is some real chilly stuff. And again, I don't know if we find much relief from the chill today. We're barely making it out of the single digits by around midday, and our wind chills are still going to be sub-zero. By the afternoon, we likely make it to the mid-teens, and we'll see some clouds building late in the day, and we're barely above zero in terms of wind chills as we head into the second half of your Sunday. So a very chilly day if you're going to be out and about running some errands, preparing for that big game later on this evening. Now, we do have more snow chances to talk about even over the next, let's say, 36 to 48 hours. Now, a lot of the day is going to be dry today. In fact, we're probably going to see a good deal of sunshine as we kind of just go throughout the midday and afternoon hours. I mentioned we'll probably see some clouds building. This is at noon. We're going to have a weak wave coming in here, and I think it's going to come sometime after dinner time this evening, maybe even a little bit later than that. This is at 5 o'clock. You can see those snow showers setting up into Illinois. And we think by around, let's say, 10, 11 o'clock midnight, we'll have this weak wave providing us some very light snow showers, little to no accumulation expected. But because we are so cold, you can see the air temperature right around 12 at this point, this will stick. And so that's going to be enough to maybe slick up some roads, and that could lead to a slick commute tomorrow morning in spots. Just kind of keep that in mind. Now, a lot of your Monday is going to be dry, specifically the morning dry. It's going to be cold tomorrow morning. I think numbers will be into the low teens, and we'll call it mostly cloudy. What I want you to be aware of is I think it's going to be a tricky drive home from work tomorrow. This is at midday, but we have a more potent system coming in. We feel probably around 4, 5, 6 o'clock in the evening. And this is going to bring widespread snow mainly to the northern half of the state. I think there could be some decent bursts with this as well. We may even be warming enough that some areas south of Indianapolis could get a bit of a mix of some sleet or maybe some rain mixing in. And then the snow should move out by early overnight Tuesday morning. I do anticipate some accumulation out of the system. So here's kind of my initial thinking right now. The heart of central Indiana, I've caught you in basically a 2 to 4 inch range. And we'll go ahead and factor in what we're going to pick up late tonight, which isn't going to be much. Most of this is going to come through tomorrow afternoon, tomorrow evening. 1 to 2 inches up north in places like Bloomington, Columbus, Greensburg, I've got you at around 1 to 2 inches as well. So that's going to create some slick conditions. Tomorrow morning, 8 for the wake-up call, 7 in Muncie, 3 in South Bend. So another very cold start to your Monday morning as we kick off the work and school week. Chapman Heating and Cooling 8-day forecast. Very active Although we're quiet on Tuesday at 23, I've got more accumulation chances for Wednesday and Thursday with highs in the low 20s and another significant cold blast. Friday, 18 and low teens Saturday and Sunday. Look at those overnight lows. Saturday morning and 4 below when you wake up Sunday morning.
I thought that negative would appear at some point, Marcus.
Here it is.
There it is. Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you. It's 5:20.